morning to my dear children of class 10. You all know we have already started with the story that you have in your textbook, The Blue Beach by Nora Burke. We have already discussed about the little girl Sylvia, how she manages to save a Gujar woman from the clutches of the crocodile, and how towards the end she finds a blue bead and she becomes so happy, and towards the end how she narrates the entire story of finding the blue bead to her mother. We all know how poor little Sylvia, this 12 years old little girl Sylvia, was. We have already discussed she did not have proper place to live in. She did not have proper food to eat. She used to take stale chapati, stale butter. She used to wear a rag, and she was very much fascinated by the wonders of the world. And the wonders were nothing but the jewelry, the ornaments to adorn herself. When she used to go to the market with her parents, she was very much fascinated by the jewelry, the satins, the cloths hung in the bazaar, hung in the market. And she really wanted to have a necklace of her own. That was her greatest desire, to have a bead. And since her family was very poor and the needle of her family was broken, they had to buy and purchase a new needle. And they did not have a needle. That's why she could not afford to make a new necklace, because a needle, was used to pierce the bead, and you could put the threads on those beads and made a necklace. But since the family's needle was broken, she could not afford to make any necklace or make any jewelry for herself. And she did not have a bead also, because they were too poor to afford those things. And we have already learned about how Sylvia and her mother, along with other women, they used to climb up the mountains above the river where the crocodile lived in order to cut the paper grass and in order to earn their livelihood. And we have next topic that was being discussed was about the Gujars. The Gujars were the nomadic people who used to, rear animals. And once the grazing area was being done, and once they finished grazing, they used to shift to other places and they sell their butter and milk produce. And that's how they used to shift their camps from one place to another. Those Gujars were nomadic people. Now today in this very class, today we shall learn about those Gujars and how Sylvia managed to cut the paper grass, and about Sylvia's encounter with the ferocious crocodile. Now today we shall discuss in brief about Sylvia's encounter with the crocodile and how she manages, or how she rescues a Gujar woman from the clutches of that ferocious, crocodile. Let us watch this short video. Let us watch this short presentation about, Sylvia's, fight with that crocodile.
Today, let us look at what happened one day when Sylvia set out with her mother and other women of her village to get paper grass. They had to walk from the village to the river carrying their hay fork and sickles. Then they crossed the river together, talking loudly and clanking their sickles and forks together as they jumped over the stepping stones. Thus, they made as much noise as they could to frighten the crocodile and crossed over safely. On the other side, they climbed a steep hillside and walked all day, climbing up wherever they could and cutting as much grass as they could find. They would later have it taken down to an agent for sale, who would pay them and send it to the paper mills. They worked all day while the agent sat on the cushions smoking hookah. While cutting the grass, Sylvia observed the great river flowing below them and her surroundings. Kingfishers and turtles were there. Marshal fish weighing more than 100 pounds also were to be found in the river. One could also see crocodiles sunning themselves on the slabs of clay at the bank, but today none were seen Sibia remembered the little clay cups that she had made as a child and that she had stored them in the little cavelets near the river. If she could paint them with marigolds and elephants, they would look very beautiful. When all of the women started their journey back home, Sibia hung back because she wanted to go and see the little clay cups. Sibia and the crocodile. By the time she reached the river, all the other women had crossed back. She was all alone. But this did not bother her. She was carrying a lot of wheat, the bundle of grass which she had cut, a hay fork and a sickle. She began crossing the river by stepping on the stones. When she was halfway through, she put her load on a big boulder to rest and stood there leaning on the fork, breathing heavily. At that moment, a Guzar woman came down to the water on the other side with two brass garas to fill water. She walked into the stepping stones. The crocodile was hiding there and he attacked her. She screamed. The garas fell and floated away in the river. The crocodile bit her leg and pulled. The woman slipped and fell on the stone and clung to a log of timber to save herself. The crocodile began pulling her with all his might. Sibia sprang. She took her hay fork and ran over the stepping stones smoothly like a rock goat. She ran even without thinking of her own safety, and in one moment she reached the screaming woman. The crocodile's eyes rolled towards Sibia. He struck at her with his mighty tail. The rock shook under the blow. But Sibia did not hesitate. She used all the force of her little body to aim at the crocodile's eyes and drove her hay fork into one of them. The crocodile reared up in pain till half his reptile body was out of the water. Then his body fell back and he disappeared.